Dlatego nie możemy tym gnojom na to pozwolić. Nie interesują nas żadne unijne przydziały imigrantów. Nie mamy zamiaru pójść na żaden kompromis. Polska nie przyjmie ani jednego imigranta. Polska nie będzie karmić obcych, kiedy jej dzieci głodują.
What's going on, guys? Politics Gaming here, and today we are doing another current events series, and this time I am actually going to be touching on another issue. Not exactly an issue, but actually a group that has actually been gaining a lot of steam in recent years. This is the Visegrad. Visegrad is a political and cultural alliance that was formed on February 15th, 1991. This is a group between the countries of Poland, Hungary, Slovakia, and the Czech Republic. The GDP of this area is $1.7 trillion. I believe most of that is held up by Poland because they are one of the bigger countries in the group. But anyway, so what is this group? What is Visegrad? If I am saying that wrong, go ahead and correct me. But what is Visegrad? Visegrad is basically a group that was created in 1991. This is actually before the collapse of the Soviet Union, but after the Czech Republic had collapsed, I believe, and after Poland's free election, in which they elected a democratic government and threw out the entire communist government. So this area was created to basically kind of push for more European integration, but today they push for the reform of the European Union, because there has been a lot of problems with the European Union on how they dictate other countries. Like, I'm not really going to be in a biased mood about that, but if you can have your own opinion, go ahead and talk about it in the comments below. I will give my opinion. My opinion on the European Union is that they need to change the way they act, because what they really do is that they push over into other countries in the form of this kind of, like, globalist agenda. I don't want to be one of those, like, people that's sitting there going, like, you're like, oh my god, like, this is globalism, like, oh my god, bad, bad, bad. No, I'm not really saying that, but, like, if you kind of look at what they do, that is kind of what they do. So, the countries of Poland, Hungary, Slovakia, and the Czech Republic, all of them were added to the European Union in the 2004 enlargement, which at the same time the Baltic states had been added into the European Union. And these countries are very strong supporters of stopping, like, this massive refugee crisis that's coming into Europe. Like, and there's actually this report I actually saw, and I think, yeah, I actually did do a little bit more research on it. The EU actually in 2015 said, okay, you guys, all members need to take in 160,000 refugees, and these countries right here are basically at the forefront of this refugee crisis, in which all these refugees are coming into Europe through these countries, and they're stopping them and saying, hey, you can't come in here, we're not going to take you. Poland is especially, like, a strong example of that, because they have not taken any refugees. I believe they have taken very little to no refugees at all. And the reason of this is because I saw a report on this, and it's actually, you can actually research it yourself. Right now, there has been no time of actual ethnic Poland. Like, ethnic Poland has never been seen, like, anywhere before. And before 1939, about 10% of the population of Poland was Jewish. And they had this entire thing about Poland, and, like, I mean, whenever you say most of the Jews that were killed were in Poland, I believe that was true, but at the same time, Poland was not a Jewish country. Only 10% of the population of Poland was Jewish. There was a lot of ethnic Poles, but at the same time, it was not, they were not the majority. It was basically kind of overrun by a lot of German, Belarusian, and Ukrainian, as well as other minorities. And they just did not have the ethnic majority that they would have liked. And a lot of nationalists now in Poland say, like, you know, this is the reason, like, why we want to do this, because, like, we want to become the dominant, like, ethnicity in our own country. Which, I mean, like, depending on how your viewpoint is, I mean, you know, some people, and I'm not putting labels on, I'm just kind of going off of what I hear and, you know, what I see. People on the left, especially in the United States, they sit there and say, you know, like, diversity is our strength. And people on the right say, you know, diversity is kind of good, but at the same time, we want to keep our own, you know, racial or ethnic majority. Like, there's this whole thing in the United States about Latinos coming in and Mexicans coming in and stuff like that, non-white people. And, like, I think it's about by 2050 that white people in the United States are going to be, like, the minority. That more minorities are going to be in the United States than there are white people. And a lot of people say this is an example of white genocide. So this is basically kind of, like, a small example of what's going on in this group. And they were, like, just kind of, like, you know, this economic union between these countries. And then they didn't really need it right after they joined the European Union, but they've still kind of stuck with it. And then so now, even at the disapproval of people like Donald Tusk, who Donald Tusk, actually, he is a Polish politician. He is from Poland. And he is the president of the European Council. And Donald Tusk says, you know, Poland, you will face consequences if you do not take in any refugees. And Poland now, which, I mean, I think it's amazing to see Poland doing this, they refuse to take in any more refugees. And they're refusing to comply with Germany and Donald Tusk and the European Union because they just don't want to take in any refugees. And I'm not pointing fingers or anything, and, like, this is just very, very controversial, and, like, all this stuff that's going on, especially with the viewpoint on Islam and stuff like that, that no terrorist attack has happened in Poland in at least, like, since the 2010 started. Since 2010, I believe there has been very little to no terrorist attack in Poland. Single-digit terrorist attacks since 2010, at least. Maybe even further. And that's basically kind of a fact. And if I'm wrong, go ahead and correct me. But it is very, very, like, interesting to see all of this. And this is basically kind of what this group is. And it's not, like, I mean, like, I'm not trying to censor all of this on immigration and stuff like that. And that's not really what this group is about. Because the Visegrad group was created just as kind of like a cultural similarity, you know, like, it's kind of like one of my friends on my Discord said, kind of like the Slavic Brotherhood. They are all four of them are Slavic nations, and they just kind of created a group, you know, like how other continents and regions do it. They just make a group, and then they say, hey, we have the same differences, or we have the same things, like, we're all Slavic. So we're going to go ahead and make a group. So that's basically kind of what it's about. But right now, especially, like, with all of this refugee stuff going on right now, it is basically, like, this whole just thing about stopping the refugees, you know, trying to maintain cultural identity and creating a better Europe in the eyes of how they see it. If you like this, go ahead and like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next current events video. I am also sorry for not posting a lot of Turkey lately. I have kind of been busy, and I've also been working on other projects. So I will start getting back into Turkey soon, and I will see you guys in the next video.